A person who says La ilaha illallah, believes in it, believe in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the Quran, is a Muslim. A person who is a Muslim, even if he doesn't pray, even if he doesn't pay zakah, even if he doesn't fast the month of Ramadan, but he is a believer, he is lazy, or he says, make dua for me, Allah guide me, inshallah, I will do it next year. He gets shy, he gets around, he runs away from righteous people, ashamed of himself or whatever. A person of that category is a believer. We call him a sinful believer. We wish for his repentance. We make dua for him. He is better than all of the unbelievers on the face of the earth, because there is no crime worse than rebelliousness against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, disbelieving in him. This is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had two people passing in front of him. He asked the Sahaba, what do you think about this man? A person, if he proposes, he'll be accepted as husband. If he knocks at the door, he will be given permission to enter. Another person, a believer, passed by, but was poor, didn't have luxury clothes. What do you think of this person? If he proposes, he will be refused. His proposal will be declined. If he comes to visit someone, he won't be let in. قَالَ هَذَا خَيْرٌ مِّن مِلْءِ الْأَرْضِ مِنْ هَذَا. This is better than the face of the earth filled of the category of that person. We should not deny the fact that in Christianity there are some ethics. But true Christians who are sticking to the ethics of Christianity are a minority in the society now, let alone the media. So the majority now, what you see, business ethics. Because it is of some profit, they stick to it. Because they will be fined by the law or sued by the law, they have to stick to the law.
سبحان من